Spurs, spur gears, pulleys, inclined planes, sprockets, screws can be used to provide mechanical advantages, change the direction and speed of rotation, convert rotational motion to linear motion, and reduce force needed to lift load. They can also be used together to create complex mechanical systems, but it is impossible to create a machine that can run infinitely without an external energy source.
Simple machines are the building blocks of more complex mechanical systems. They are used in many different mechanisms to make work easier and more efficient. These machines include levers, pulleys, gears, screws, inclined planes, wedges, and wheels and axles. Each of these simple machines has its own unique characteristics and advantages that make it useful in specific applications.
There are several ways to modify a machine to provide greater mechanical advantage. Number 1. Change the location of the fulcrum or pivot point. Moving the fulcrum closer to the load will increase the mechanical advantage of a lever. 2. Use multiple levers. Using multiple levers in series will increase the mechanical advantage of the machine. Number 3. Increase the number of pulleys. Using more pulleys in a pulley system will increase the mechanical advantage of the machine. Number 4. Change the gear ratio. Increasing the number of teeth on a driven gear will increase the mechanical advantage of the gear system. Number 5. Change the pitch of the screw. Increasing the pitch of the screw will increase the mechanical advantage of the screw system. Number 6. Change the angle of an inclined plane. Increasing the angle of an inclined plane will increase the mechanical advantage in the machine.
Using different simple machines together can accelerate an object by changing its direction and or its speed. For example, a pulley system can be used to change the direction of force applied, while a gear system can be used to change the speed and torque of a rotating shaft. In addition, a lever can be used to increase the mechanical advantage and reduce the amount of force needed to move an object. We used poster board for the circle and the spinner. We cut the same shape 3 times and put them together so it would be more solid. We also used 5 bearings, 1 for the circle and 4 for the spinner. We also used sticks as a border on where the bearing on the spinner will pass through, and as well to connect the spinner and the circle to the stand. And finally, we used wood for the base and the stand.